students, this video discusses about E-plane T-junction. So in case of E-plane T-junction, the waveguide has been cut along E-plane or vertical and another waveguide is inserted into the junction. So that will be port 3, port 1 and port 2. So the main property compared to H-plane T-junction, main difference is that when you are feeding power to port 3, it gets divided equally between port 1 and 2, but with a phase shift of 180 degree because of the corners of the E-plane T-junction. So the wave will get shifted by 180 degree. So in the diagram, it can be seen that the face of the E-field is being shifted. So similarly, you can see here when input has been fed, the output is varying its direction in each of the ports. Now, in order to find out the S matrix, again we have to consider the characteristics of E-plane T-junction. So again, when you consider feeding power to port 3, it gets divided equally between port 1 and 2, but with a phase shift of 180 degree. So feeding power input at port 3 and getting the output at port 1 can be written as S31. And input at port 3 and taking power out of port 2 can be written as S32. And as there is a change in phase, it should be denoted by a negative sign. So we can write this as S32 is equal to minus S31. So negative sign denotes opposite in phase. Now next property is S33 equal to 0, that is assuming port 3 is perfectly matched. Now from symmetry property we can write Sij is equal to Sji. So we can write S21 is equal to S12, that is considering the general matrix and then applying the symmetry property, we can write this as, again considering S21 will be equal to S12, S23 will be equal to S32, which will be also equal to minus S31. We have written it in equation 1, equal to minus S13. Similarly, S31 will be equal to S13. So we can write the final S matrix can be written as, substituting all the values, we can write the S matrix in its general form, and also S33 is equal to 0. Now we have to consider the next property. That is apply unitary property. So as per unitary property, S into its conjugate will be equal to U. So we can write the same matrix and its conjugate should be written. That is, write the same matrix. And its conjugate, that is S11 conjugate, S12 conjugate, S13 conjugate, S12 conjugate, S22 conjugate, minus S13 conjugate, S13 conjugate, minus S13 conjugate, and 0. That will be equal to 100 010 001. So now apply matrix multiplication, that is considering each equation, we can write this as, first row multiplied with first column can be written as, S S11 square plus S12 square plus S13 square is equal to 1. Now applying second, multiplying second row and second column of second matrix can be written as S12 square plus S22 square plus S13 square is equal to 1. Now considering third row and the third column, that is S13 square plus S13 square plus 0 will be equal to 1. Again, third row and first column, multiplying both of them, it can be written as S13 into S11 conjugate minus S13 into S12 conjugate plus 0 is equal to 0. So from equation 8, directly it can be written as S13 square is equal to 1. That means S13 will be equal to 1 by root 2. Now compare equation 6 and 7. So when you compare 6 and 7, some of the terms are common. So comparing it, we can write S22 is equal to S11. Can be written as S22 equal to S11. Let it be equation 11. Now consider equation 9. So from equation 9, S13 can be taken outside. So S13 taken outside, what is remaining will be S13 into S11 conjugate minus S12 conjugate. So here S13 cannot be 0, that is when you are feeding power to port 1, surely some power comes out of port 3. So that cannot be equal to 0. The only term that can be 0 is the other term. So we can write it as S11 conjugate minus S12 conjugate is equal to 0. That means S11 conjugate will be equal to S12 conjugate. So now here again complex conjugate can be removed. So we get it as S11 is equal to S12. So also substituting some of the values, that is equation 10 and equation 12, considering S13 equal to 1 by root 2 and S12 equal to S11, we can write the equation as S11 square plus S11 square plus 1 by 2 is equal to 1. So we can write this as 2 times S11 square is equal to 1 by 2. So S11 will be equal to 1 by 2, which is equal to S12 and S22. So we have now got all the values of the S parameter. So we can write the final equation as 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 2, minus 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2 and 0. Again, this can be written in general form as B is equal to S into A. So, writing the final equation B1, B2, B3 is equal to, writing the equation into A1, A2, A3.